within 10 or 15 minutes of the blast, we were already starting to collect evidence that would be crucial to the investigation.
We have not charged anyone at this time. We are asking the public to help us supplement the investigation.
The decency and commitment to the job that Ed has, it's awesome.
We don't call it what we already know it is. And a cell is activated and they hit Chicago or New York or Washington. What happens then?
Ed Davis felt as if his city was attacked under his watch and that this was personal.
I had a great team up there, and a lot of it's got to do with putting together a good team.
These guys are somebody's friends, neighbors, co-workers.
They don't look like prototypical jihadists to me.
What does a prototypical jihadist look like, Rick? You got a photo of one?
We worked together as a team that week. Did we always agree on everything 100% of the time? No. But that would have been unhealthy if we did.
Rick felt that in this case, even though it's a tense situation and we definitely have tense moments, this was a team. He said to me many times that the motto was one fight, one team, one fight, one team.
We had competing points of view, the discussion of which led to the best decisions that could be possibly made.
Clock is ticking. World is watching. There is a terrorist loose in our city. He's already murdered three people and may be emboldened by what he's done here today. It is our duty to catch him before he kills again.
We knew each other and we trusted each other. We knew what our respective strengths were. Everybody brought their best.
These three characters are making decisions that will affect many people, and not just the people of Boston. Let's get a PBA out immediately. All civilians are asked to please shelter in place. Every inch of this city is getting searched.
Patrick embodied the city of Boston, this resolve not to let this take us down.
The decisions that they're making may have repercussions to how the country is going to deal with things from this point on.
When you consider that investigation required the forensic equivalent of a search for a needle in a haystack, that was a pretty extraordinary accomplishment.